had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped. They just watched. Had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who was the dummy to doubt? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again.
Tonight, from Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, Georgia, it's week 11 of the NFL on EA Sports. Falcons taking on Teddy Bridgewater and the Carolina Panthers.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the Atlanta Falcons. Again, everyone, Brandon Gordon along with Charles Davis. And Charles, we take a look at this Falcons team as they interplay. They come off a disappointment last time out that put an end to their modest three-game win streak. On the other side of the field for the visiting Panthers, they've been the talk of the NFL so far. 9 wins in their first 9 games.
And some people subscribe to the theory that a loss might not be the worst thing for them. They've had it easy all year long. How did they do handling adversity?
The lane opens here. He's past the 30. Matt Ryan, the longtime Falcon, a veteran who's been in the league since 08, ready to guide this Atlanta offense.
You talk about the pause that refreshes. I think it's come at a perfect time of the year for them, hasn't it? You know, it's the season is starting to wind down, got a little bit of a break. But how about the guy calling the signals? He's got to be excited about that because now he didn't just get a game plan for 1 week. He was able to work on it for 2 weeks. I can't wait to see if they have anything special in store for him today.
Now it's Ryan. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley.
That's good.
And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 23 yards on the play. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. First carry here for Todd Gurley. And he's going to be stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there for him. Second down. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10.
At the 30-yard line.
From the shotgun, Ryan. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. From the gun, it's Ryan. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
Yeah, it was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their their performance.
No touchdown there, but if that first drive is any indication, looks like they're going to have a pretty good day passing the football.
I would say confidence would have to be pretty high after that first drive, able to throw it almost at will. You're exactly right. They didn't get the touchdown, but 3 points serves as a nice notice about how this offense is going to move.
Offensively for Carolina, Teddy Bridgewater will be at the controls, the talented quarterback out of Louisville.
It's pretty much become the norm when we see guys come out before a game and go through the route tree with their receivers. I thought it was exciting for us to see the exact same thing happen in practice.
He's so meticulous, isn't he?
He really is, and it's not just a one-time-a-week thing. They work on it all the time, trying to hone that fine edge. They want to see if they can get in sync and stay in sync in this one.
And not a whole lot doing there, as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. On second and nine, Bridgewater under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Dante Fowler able to record his fifth sack of the season. So Bridgewater needing to work a little magic after that sack on a third and long. Third from the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. And that is incomplete.
Bridgewater's pass intended for Curtis Samuel.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
On fourth down, they do snap it to Bridgewater. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons offense. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. Throwing at a very strong gain of 24. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number three man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Operating from the gun, Ryan. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Calvin Ridley, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons push further out in front. An out route there for the score, a quick out route there for the score.
Yeah, you're not really surveying the defense on this one. You're just counting on timing, making this play happen. 1-2, ball's out of his hands, knows where he's going, just puts it to the outside. Touchdown.
And a penalty marker's down on the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive. Well, that holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
On first and 10, Bridgewater. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tuck rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm is going forward. Incomplete pass. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
It's a gain of 25 yards. First down, Panthers.
Bridgewater, a play fake to McCaffrey. He'll look to throw. He's going to look deep for Moore. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Panthers are able to get this back within a touchdown. Well, they went play action there and set it up nicely for him. I mean, he can flat fly, and they hit him downfield.
And it doesn't take much to create that extra bit of space that a guy of his speed needs. If you go play action, all you want is just a moment where the guy's covering, take their attention somewhere else, and then he's by him. And once he's by him, there's no catching him. As they always like to say, if a receiver's even to a defensive back, that means he's leaving.
Unless that DB is Charles Davis, right?
In that case, he left me a long time ago.
Come on now.
Trust me.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. Now a crease here as he's past the 30.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
3 yards the game there, second down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed-out position because he creates mismatches with his size. A slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Kaywan Short able to record his 5th sack of the season. And partner, it's safe to say that the secondary really contributed to that sack.
Yeah, nickel set, 5 defensive backs. They covered everything. Nowhere to go with the football. But my question is, why didn't he throw it away?
On 4th down, the Falcons send out Sterling Hoffrichter to punt. Christian McCaffrey deep for Carolina. Fielded at the 33. So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. The Carolina offense about ready to go. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today. So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Good coverage that time by the linebacker, Deion Jones.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up 3rd and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
And he finds Cook. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on 3rd down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. They'll throw again, Bridgewater. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. First down, Bridgewater. Open man is Samuel, complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time 18 more and a 1st down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker.
Bridgewater's pass.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. And while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. He's looking for Ridley again. And it's second down. To throw again. Ryan. And on the left side here, Wilson. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Play action. It's Ryan. Left side completion to Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 47. They go play action now. Ryan. Short throw underneath to Hurst. 7 yards the pick up there. 2 minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7 our score.
Brings up second and 3. At the 40-yard line.
Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Kaywan Short in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Enough to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
So the sack pushes him back, and now 3rd and long for Ryan and the Falcons. From the gun, Ryan. Wilson snags it, left side. Oh, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here we go, it's Gurley. And they are going to stop him on 4th and 1 as he'll wind up going backwards. Todd Gurley unable to get it past the line. And the Panthers will get the football back. Even though they didn't get it, probably the right call. Too long for a field goal and just not a whole lot to gain from a punt there.
Yeah, you wouldn't have really netted very much yardage if you pumped the ball, right? And the thing about a field goal, and you know this from so much experience, the longer the field goal, the lower it comes out off the kick, right? Which means it's got a better chance of being blocked. So you're taking a chance either way. I like the fact they went for it.
Now a throw to the end zone on 1st down, but it winds up incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for, but it'll be 2nd down.
It's now 2nd and 10.
From the gun, Bridgewater. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
1st down, Carolina.
Bridgewater now looking to throw on 1st. He's got it for a Panther touchdown.
Complete.
Curtis Samuel, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers have taken the lead. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on 1st and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got them down close. I think that big play left them reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you? Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
And that makes it 14-10. Just a 4-play drive that time. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown.
Graham Gano to kick off for Carolina.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. Oh, a good looking return set up here.
The Falcons take over 1st and 10 at their own 39-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
To the right side and complete to Hurst. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. From the gun on third down, Ryan. It's caught, Jones. Yeah, they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And we're going to get a timeout.
Brandon
with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
A 29-yard attempt.
The kick by McManus is good. And that will do it for this first half.
14.
And now due to a pair of time constraints, 14. We fast forward to the beginning of the second half.
Set to kick off.
Makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
First and 10.
There's DJ Moore as he and the rest of the offense head back out there. And they've got to figure out how to stop some of the highlights that we're seeing on the screen here.
And what it feels like, he's trying to say it doesn't matter what you put out here. I am having a big-time performance. I'm playing at a big-time level. Just keep throwing me the football.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts of the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
From the 27, Bridgewater. That'll be taken in by Anderson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4.
From the 44, Bridgewater. That's going to be caught by Samuel.
Bridgewater's pass.
5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on 3rd down.
And it's 3rd down.
They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he won't be close to a 1st down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
A big roll of the dice on 4th and 1, but it pays off. They convert.
Panthers.
On play action, it's Bridgewater. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore, but it's going to be 2nd down.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
On 2nd down, Bridgewater again. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. And that's going to be good for another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 29-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a 1st down. A 1st down throw for Bridgewater. Quick slam caught by Moore. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. And again, it's Bridgewater. Flush to his right. And he's going to go down just outside of the five, right around the six-yard line.
Second goal. Last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
Third and goal for Bridgewater. And it's caught. A gain of five, but not enough. Leads to a fourth and goal.
Just shy of the goal line. A gain of 5 yards leads to fourth down.
From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Moore with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Panthers add on to their lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
For the extra point. And with that, the lead is up to 8. So that drive spans 13 plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off. 13.
Graham Gano to kick off for Carolina.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things work well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
At the 39-yard line.
They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. It's a 6-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with 3rd down coming up.
Brings up 3rd down.
Here's Ryan. And Jones hands it over the middle. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It's a gain of 16, 1st down Falcons. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that 3rd down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is, because he understands how to get open in key situations.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd.
1 quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Right there. 54, right there.
looking to throw again on second down. Ryan, short throw underneath to Hurst, and he'll go down at the 28. Catch number 44 of on the year. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 28-yard line.
Again, Ryan. That's caught over the middle by Hurst. A gain of six there on first. So second and four from the 22.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
It's a first down on a gain of 10. To throw again is Ryan. At the four. And the Falcons are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
First and goal.
They'll try and push it in with Gurley. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Todd Gurley. His sixth touchdown of the season. And now the Falcons are within a two-point conversion of tying up the game. But he is not going to make it. It's a big play by the defense, and they're going to hold on to their two-point lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. DJ Moore, the Carolina offense, about to take over once again.
Seems like the measuring stick for a receiver for a great game is 100 yards. Well, he's well past that now.
And as we analyze how he's getting them, that's where it really becomes fun because, let's face it, they keep sending coverage at him, keep trying to put the pressure on, and he finds ways downfield and finds openings. That's a really crafty receiver.
A gain of three, second down. And they're going to speed things up here.
A three-yard pickup brings up second
down. On second and seven, Bridgewater. Open man is Robbie Anderson. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 11 yards there, first down.
And the Panther, first down.
They'll try and burn some clock now with McCaffrey. And able to get a couple as he's across the 40 to the 41. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down.
Second and eight.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down.
You'll forgive me if I get excited about what we just saw there, won't you? I know I'm supposed to be neutral here, but those were terrific plays back-to-back defensively. They know what the mission is. They've got to force a punt here if they want to have a chance to win the game.
They absolutely do. Steps one and two done. Now they need this third step. 2 minutes remain, and that's our score differential as well. 2 points here in the fourth quarter. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Bridgewater going to give this to McCaffrey. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Bridgewater. And he's got it complete to Anderson. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 16. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. He's down inside the 10 to the 8, and it comes on a gain of 8. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Again, it's McCaffrey. he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. That play gets him 6 yards and sets them up with a first and goal.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Ground McCaffrey, and he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown Carolina. Touchdown. Christian McCaffrey with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year, and the Panthers add on to their lead. Solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up. Meaning, when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
And that makes it a 9-point game. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays. And the last play on the drive, the touchdown run from Christian McCaffrey.
Graham Gano to kick off for Carolina.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. Oh, a good return up past the 30.
Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 35-yard line.
So Ryan and the Falcons down by 9, a little under a minute to go. It's a tall order, but they do begin with decent field position on first down. Ryan. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Dante Jackson picks it. Now the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down 2 scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And with the defense out of timeouts, powerless to stop the clock, this should just be a couple of kneel downs. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. 3 tight ends are out there. Following the interception, here's Bridgewater. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
Bridgewater's
a big gain there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column.
First down, Carolina.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
First and goal.
Throwing here, Bridgewater. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And I know I'm not breaking any news when I say that any road win in this league is a good one.
No doubt.
But it's a double bonus when you get a victory on the road in your division.
And when you start a season, each team breaks down their schedule in different ways. Some do it every 4 games, right? Let's go quarterly. Others say, listen, we've got to take care of our home field. And, you know, out of a 16-game season, if you get 8 at home, let's at least win 7 at home and split our road games. That's what you're trying to get done. So you're exactly right. A road win, precious, especially within the division.
So for the Panthers, they keep on rolling 10-0 now to start the year. And now they'll have a few extra days here before they face Miami next week. Meanwhile, for Atlanta, it's a bit of a...